हाय एंड वेलकम टू कनिकास नर्सिंग एकेडमी. हम लोग ECG के बारे में डिस्कस कर रहे थे एंड टुडे विल बी कंटिन्यूइंग आवर नेक्स्ट क्लास ऑफ ECG. ECG मैंने आपको पहले भी बताया था कि स्टूडेंट्स काफ़ी डिफिकल्टीज फेस करते हैं फॉर रीडिंग द ECG स्ट्रिप. तो आई हैव जस्ट मेड दिस प्रेजेंटेशन फॉर ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स टू लर्न अबाउट द बेसिक कंसेप्ट ऑफ ECG, हाउ टू रीड द इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स इन ECG. एंड लास्ट क्लास में हम लोगों ने कार्डियक कंडक्शन सिस्टम के बारे में बात की थी एंड वी हैव डिस्कस दैट हार्ट्स मसल्स और कार्डियक मसल्स दे हैव द थ्री स्पेशलाइज्ड प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ ऑटोमेटिसिटी, एक्साइटेबिलिटी एंड कंडक्टिविटी. ऑल्सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द कार्डियक कंडक्शन सिस्टम. SNO, विच इज नोन एज द पेसमेकर ऑफ द हार्ट, इज इनिशिएटिंग द इलेक्ट्रिकल इम्पल्स एंड द इलेक्ट्रिकल इम्पल्स इज गोइंग टू द AV नोड. फ्रॉम AV नोड इट इज गोइंग टू द बंडल ऑफ फिश, देन from the bundle of fish it will be traveling towards the Purkinje fibers and the ventricles and the cardiac conduction cycle will be completed. Next we have discussed about the pattern of ECG boxes, because we have to see what is the breakdown of ECG, how does this PQRST forms. So what we have discussed was, this is a big square and in between this big square we have 25 small squares. So each small square corresponds to the time second of 0.04 seconds. Remember 0.04 seconds, and since there are 5 boxes, so what we are doing here is multiplying this 0.04 by 5, it comes out to be 0.2 seconds. This is the basic thing, because we will be reading the ECG from these boxes only, 0.04 seconds small square and 0.02 seconds big square. So we will be continuing our class from next point, that is the breakdown of ECG only. This you can see now how to read the ECG. First of all, we have to see the formation of P wave. As you can see in this image, that this is the formation of the P wave. And how it is formed? P wave is always formed when the SA node has fired the impulse and it is traveling throughout the atria to cause the atrial contraction. So, for an easy way to remember this is that P wave gives us the information about the atrial contraction. Coming to the time period of P wave, it is approximately 0.1 seconds in length. Coming back to the same point, 0.1 seconds in length means one small square was 0.04 seconds and 2.5 small squares will be making about 0.1 seconds. So remember, P wave is equal to 0.1 second. Next we move on further towards the formation of PR interval. This you can see the PR interval. Here also you can see this is P and this is R. So PR interval usually is giving the time that the impulse takes from traveling to the atria towards the ventricle. P wave was giving us the information about the atrial contraction. PR interval tells us how much time the impulse takes between atrial contraction and ventricular contraction. So the time period is 0.12 seconds to 0.20 seconds, or we can say 3 to small squares. 0.20 to 0.2, 0.12 to 0.20 seconds, that is 3 to 5 small squares. So we have discussed regarding P wave formation, that is atrial contraction, and PR interval, that is time period between the atrial contraction and the ventricular contraction. Next we quickly move to the QRS complex. You can see this is a pointed complex, and this here also you can see the pointed complex of QRS, which basically gives us the information about the ventricular contraction. Ventricles, they are now contracting, and the ventricular contraction can be seen on the ECG as this pointed complex, which we call as the QRS complex. And on ECG, this QRS should be less than 0.12 seconds, or we can say less than 3 small squares. Remember 0.04 multiplied by 3, it comes out to be 0.12, and it has to be less than 0.12 seconds. So three things which we have discussed:
P wave formation, PR interval and the QRS complex. We'll quickly move on. The next one, that is the T wave. The formation of a T wave, you can see here, T wave. So it gives us the information regarding the ventricular repolarization. There are two things, depolarization and repolarization. Depolarization means contraction, repolarization means no associated activity of the heart. That means the ventricles, they are relaxing for the next impulse to take place, and that is manifested by the T wave, and they are recharging for the next cardiac cycle. After which we will get this isoelectric line, and again the new P, new QRS, new T, then isoelectric, then P, QRS and T, likewise it will be formed. So I hope yahan tak sabhi kuch clear ho gaya hai. Now basic interpretation, or what do we need in an ECG, that we will be learning, and there are 5 step method to read the ECG. We will be studying how to note the heart rate from the ECG, how to note the heart rhythm from the ECG strip, how to measure the P wave on an ECG, how to measure the PR interval and the QRS complex. So we will stop our class here and we will continue to discuss about these 5 parameters on ECG in the next class. Thank you.